Well, next tonight we're going to meet a young woman from Consett. She's one of a handful of female frontline railway technicians.
Well, she loves her job and now she's urging other girls to consider an engineering career.
When I wanted to apply for a job in engineering, I had some negative responses just because I was female. That only makes me more determined to prove them wrong and to be better than them. I'm definitely very feminine and I like to bring that into the workplace. I've got pink tools, I've got my nails done all the time. You know, everyone knows that I'm very feminine when I'm at work. I never thought that I'd end up doing a job like this because I always thought growing up that this was more of a man's job, but now I'm actually in the job, I'm determined to teach other girls that that's not the case. I'm Nichola, I'm 21 and I'm from Consett. I'm working with fixers to try and inspire more young women to take up engineering as a career.
Women make up just under 10% of all engineers in the UK, and that's a really low proportion compared to other European countries. Many women would be brilliant engineers and they're not doing it because their parents, their teachers, their careers advisors, I never talk to them about it, and so they don't even consider it.
I started working with Network Rail via their apprenticeship scheme and now I have a job as a signalling technician. I'm the only woman in my team and on the front line, 97% of all employees are male. So there's very, very few women doing the job that I do. Today I've come to meet some railway engineering students at the Newcastle College Rail Academy. Out of 180 students on the course, only 6 are women. What was it that made you want to pursue a career in engineering?
Well, my dad's a joiner, so I've always been into like that kind of stuff. Like I'm always like trying to build things and that.
I think some women are put off because some of the work is quite hard. But if you can do the job, I don't see what the problem is. I think women sometimes have a slightly different thought process to how problems can be solved. They do bring a different dimension into work sometimes, I think.
I think we need to try and encourage more women into engineering because there's so much talent available with all the young women in the country, and I feel that if more of them were confident enough to apply for a job in engineering, then they could make a real, real difference. Do you think that there's any truth to the stigma that women can't really do a job in engineering?
I think gender has absolutely nothing to do with how qualified a person can be in any sector whatsoever.
If you go in with quite an open mind, you know, there's a lot to be learned.
Yeah.
But I think sometimes the only people who sort of pull you down sometimes is yourself.
Yeah. I'd be incredibly honoured if I was able to change the mindset of young women into thinking, you know what, I will apply for that engineering job that I've been thinking about, then I'll be like so grateful to have been a part of that, and I think that I'll have been helping them to make such a good life-changing decision. It would be amazing.
Well, that report was put together with the help of the campaign group Fixers, and if you want more information, we'll put a link on our website, itv.com/tyneteas.